So we're here in the shop today. We are talking about shock absorbers, compression, rebound, and understanding what they do on your car. Yeah.
The compression and rebound are very important as far as controlling the motions of the car. So as the shock's going to compress, you can imagine a wheel and tire hitting a speed bump. This shock absorbs it. As the wheel and tire comes back down over the speed bump, the shock extends with the rebound, returning the wheel and tire to the original position. Now, the way that this is done is through the oil in the shock, and how the adjustment controls how quickly or firmly that oil is able to circulate, which translates to the softness or firmness of the shock.
Right, so where you might have a fixed valve shock that has one valving, right? And it might be different on compression, different on rebound. There's various types. These shocks here, they have just the adjuster, so basically you have multiple shocks in one.
Yeah, you can soften or firm things. Our single adjustable here, it will soften or firm both directions of the shock. So, and you'll feel it in the car just by adding a couple clicks. So,
And that's key is what you feel in the car, right? So whether your goal is ride quality, whether your goal is performance, you can tune for a variety of different scenarios, and these shocks allow you to do that. So let's talk about someone who's building maybe a hot rod, a muscle car, you know, classic truck, whatever it may be, for street driving. Yeah. What are you doing shock valving wise, or what do you look for ride quality?
In a street rod or a cruising application, you probably want a little bit softer side of the shock valving. You do want enough valving to dampen the spring so that as you're hitting bumps and imperfections in the road, the car is not bouncing.
It absorbs impact, and so it doesn't rock you around in the cockpit a whole lot.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Where now on rebound, if ride quality is your goal, you can get away with a little bit stiffer rebound. So at that softer compression, it absorbs that initial hit. But that rebound then slows the travel of how the chassis returns back to its static height. You know, of course, you can go too stiff on rebound, and that will start to have a negative effect. But oftentimes, you run a softer compression, a little bit firmer rebound.
Yeah, you'll have the softer compression. The wheel and tire will absorb the bump or imperfection in the road, and then it will slowly, or more slowly, return back to its original position. Usually, ends up in a really nice, comfortable ride.
So now, let's talk about drag racing, right? So you see a lot of cars; they're going to leave the line, carry the wheels. You want a lighter rebound, right?
Absolutely. Yeah, the rebound or extension of this shock is gonna be what's allowing the front end of that car to come up, which the reason we do that is to transfer the weight to the back tires. So we do want a softer rebound. We want some spring energy in there and help get everything coming up.
Right. And on the compression side, so that doesn't fall flat on its face and you take out the oil pan and the headers, stiffer compression?
Definitely. With a car that goes airborne especially, we want to have a stiffer compression so that it absorbs that car as it comes back down, doesn't compress the spring so much that the oil pan is now part of the track.
Right. And so now let's just say, okay, so you got your straight line coverage, you got your more of your ride quality coverage there, but what if handling is what you're after?
On handling, autocross, road racing, we'll usually want a firmer of compression as well as rebound, just to keep the car flat going around turns. You don't want a whole lot of sway in the car, so that's usually where we'll run a firmer valving.
Yeah, where you see a lot of people, they'll update the sway bars and there's good gains to be made there. The shocks will have a huge, huge role in how the car handles. And you can tune for different scenarios as well with an adjustable shock, whether it be, you know, cruising on the back roads, you want something that handles, or at your autocross you hit on the weekend.
Ultimately, at the end of the day, the shock valving is what's going to control the motions of the car. So whatever type of driving you do, the shock is going to help you achieve that if you have the ability to adjust it.
So if you're intimidated by the idea of adjustable shocks, don't be, because the knob's there for a reason. You can turn that shock and have it super soft, super stiff, or anywhere in the middle.
Yeah, I mean, one of the fun things about having adjustable shocks is playing with them and feeling the difference in the ride.
That's right. And you can find the ride that's right for you and basically tailor it for whatever your needs are. So if you're building a car or looking to upgrade the suspension that's on your car, check out QA1.net. We do have different resources, articles, videos that help you tune for drag racing, for autocross, just try to get your car to ride and handle better. We have all the different resources to help you there. And
you can definitely call the tech line too.
You might talk to Steve.
You might.
Thanks, guys. Appreciate it.
Go drive it.